Yamaha's PGM1 and PGX1 are paging stations that can be used with the MTX 5D or MRX 7D. They can be networked via a Dante network and using power over Ethernet or PoE. There are 8 buttons on each paging station, allowing you to specify broadcast regions in detail and to select from numerous messages. If you have a larger system, you can add up to 2 PGX1 units so that you can select more broadcast regions and more messages. For each MTX-MRX system, you can use MTX-MRX Editor to install up to 4 PGM1 units. One of these PGM1 units can be specified as the priority mic. Before we go into more detail about how to set up the unit, let's have a look at the hardware. There is a mic input jack for the paging mic, 8 select buttons that allow you to assign zones or messages, and 1 push-to-talk button. The editor has a template that can be used to create labels for this area. For PGX1, there are 8 zone message select buttons that extend the zone numbers just like PGM1. On the rear panel of PGM1, there's a rotary switch and dip switches to specify the ID of each individual PGM1 unit in the MTX-MRX systems network. There is an Ethernet port to connect the unit to a PoE switch, such as Yamaha's SWR2100P series, that provides power over Ethernet. On the bottom panel, there is a dedicated connector for connection to the PGX1. You can extend the paging station by connecting the PGM1 and PGX1. To connect the unit to the system, you need to connect the PoE switch to the MTX 5D or MRX 7D system. Then, connect the PGM1 to the PoE switch. When you've connected the PGM1 to the MTX-MRX system, you need to set up the unit in the MTX-MRX editor software. The setup procedure is slightly different between MRX 7D and MTX 5D. Firstly, I'll show you how to set up PGM1 and PGX1 on MRX 7D. In the device configuration wizard, you can add up to 4 units of PGM1. For now, I'll add just 1 unit to my system. The MRX 7D and PGM1 will be assigned with a unit ID automatically by default. Here, we'll just use the default unit ID. On this page, you can also add PGX1, but we'll leave that for now. Now, we can click Finish since we don't need to add any other devices. Next, we need to assign the input of the paging mic to Dante in the external I/O tab, since the paging mic transmits using Dante. Here, we can see that PGM1 is being identified as a Dante device using only 1 channel. Here, we patch the input of PGM1 to the input channel 1 on Dante. Next, in the MRX Designer, we've already set up a simple paging system for this demo. Firstly, looking at the paging component, you can see we have 4 paging mic inputs. Then, 1 SD input for programmed audio such as opening and closing chimes. There are 24 programs to input up to 24 different audio sources such as background music for different rooms. Each of the program inputs will be sent to different zones respectively. For example, PGM1 to Zone 1 and so on. For this demo, we've prepared 1 paging mic input, 1 SD card input, and 1 BGM input to the paging component. We want to have the same program sent to 8 different zones, so we will have the same audio input routed to each program input. Then, all zone outputs are routed to the analog outputs. Next, we'd like to set up the paging component. Double-click to open the paging component, then click Settings to assign the command to each button on the PGM1 and PGX1. Here, we can assign the command to activate the paging function to each zone to a different button. We can also use Zone Group to activate paging functions to multiple groups at the same time. And SD Message, which allows you to play back a preset message, or All Zone Off to deactivate the paging functions to all of the zones. here, we will assign zones 1 to 8 to buttons 1 to 8 on the PGM1. In Property, we will set the opening and closing chime using the audio that's already saved on the SD card. When we press the Push to Talk button, the chime will be played automatically. And finally, you can adjust the three parameters of the gain section of the paging mic input. When all settings are done, you can compile and go online to synchronize all the data to the MRX 7D. If you'd like to check the setup procedure, you can also select Help, Operation Manual, and PGM1 and Paging Component on the MRX Designer. Next, we'll explain the setup for PGM1 with MTX 5D. Basically, it's very similar to the setup on MRX 7D, but as you know, MTX 5D is not an open architecture processor. Therefore, you do not have to customize the system design like MRX 7D. Firstly, add the PGM1 and MTX 5D with device configuration window in the same way as we did with MRX 7D. Again, you'll need to assign the input of the paging mic to Dante in the external I/O tab. And, on input page, we need to patch the input of channel 1 to Dante, so the signal from the paging mic will be sent to input channel 1. Next, open the matrix page. As all input channels are patched to all zones by default, it's necessary to switch off the patching of the channel for the paging mic. Please note that we're using Stereo In 1 for background music here, so make sure that Stereo In 1 is patched to all zones. When all the settings are done, you can go online to synchronize all the data to the MTX 5D. And again, if you want to check the setup procedure, you can also select Help, Operation Manual, PGM1 and Paging Component on the MTX editor. Now the setup is complete, let me show you how it works. Select the zone to which we want to make an announcement, then press the Push to Talk button, and you'll be able to hear the chime, and when the LED turns red, you can speak into the mic. You can see that the signal is being sent to Zone 1. Press the Push to Talk button again to turn off the mic. Now you can choose another zone to make another announcement. Thanks for watching.